I'm gonna leave this wide for just a second to show you what I believe will up your game a lot in scent control. And I don't mean body odor, I mean using scents to bring in bigger bucks.
Mossberg's Rugged American Hunter with Jason Cruz.
Now here, this scent wick is behind me just a little bit, but it is about at the level of a deer's nose. That's the first thing you want to do. Some guys put their scents high thinking it's going to carry out forever. I don't think that's going to be to your best interest. Keep it on his nose level if you can at all do that. Let's take it one step further. I had to learn this the hard way. I believe the average deer hunter is really hurting themselves with the use of scents. Not that they're using scents is bad, it's that we use too much. Think about it. The average whitetail's olfactory glands are just monumentally more acute than any human being. Most deer hunters just use too much. It's the equivalent of, you know, you've gone through the mall when you're forced to go to the mall, you know, and you have to walk through the perfume section with your wife to get somewhere else. And you're like, oh my goodness. I mean, it's so overstimulating. I really believe that's what most deer hunters do. They use too much scent on that wick. And think about it, he recognizes it as estrus or tarsal, but he's like, oh my word, I've never smelt a deer like something that reeks like that. So you would do well to back off. It doesn't take near as much scent as you think it does. Charlie Alsheimer is one of the most recognized deer researchers on the planet. And I asked him one time, Charlie, how far do you think a whitetail can smell something? He said, well, that's up for debate. He said, I can tell you this, in my research facility, deer will stand at my fence and the nearest tree line was hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of yards away. I can't remember if he said it was 800 yards, but it was a long way. He said, during the rut, every buck will stand on that fence looking into that tree line way, way out there. He said, that's a hot doe. That's how far they can smell that just on a normal day. I put one scent wick behind me. Obviously you want to hunt with the wind in your face, so put a scent wick behind you in case a deer does come around behind you. Bigger bucks are prone to do that. Put one out there in front of you 40, 50, 60 yards to opposite that and just control it. Always remember, a little dab will do you.
You know, Mossberg is creating a ton of content on YouTube. Tips, strategies, whether you like gun tips, shooting, tactical three gun, whether you're into waterfowl, ducks, deer, plinking, I'm telling you, Mossberg has a YouTube planet that is right there waiting on you.